Good evening, this is Kirsty Bentley-Taylor from This Hacky Guru, coming to you live underneath the beautiful Hunter's Moon in October the 23rd in the UK. So it's 9 o'clock in the night here. The moon has been rising all day. And it's a really special moon, which is why I wanted to do a full moon release ritual with you guys all today. Today is all about the feminine energy. It's all about the moon rising in Taurus, which is an earth sign. It's also in the middle of Venus retrograde, so there's a lot of stuff going on between the planets. We'll get back to that later. But it's all really about self-love, and it's about standing tall in who you are and setting boundaries that are healthy for you in your relationships, not just with other people, not just with your other spouse or with children or work relationships, but also with yourself, how it is that you see yourself and how it is that you talk to yourself going forward. So I'm going to go through like just a few little things. I do a full moon ritual, release ritual, probably every other month, if I'm honest. I tend to kind of just miss a month just because life gets busy and it goes on. But when there's something really special to kind of talk about and to celebrate, I get right on in there. And it's really helped me in the past, helped me let go of thought processes, negative belief patterns, things like that, that I've found that I lean into. And I like the significance of the full moon. I like the fact that it signifies kind of death and rebirth right at the same time. So traditionally, the new moon would be the sort of the rebirthing time, the time when you start new projects, when you think about how kind of, you know, anything new that you want to get on with, new relationships, new ways that you want to live, starting diets, intention setting, all that sort of thing. That would be around the new moon. But the full moon is just as powerful, as it signifies really the end of things that you want to bring to a close. Lots of stagnant energy sticks around over the course of the month. And especially stuff that might have been brought up for the new moon. You know, you know that you need to release sort of stuff to be able to start. Like, for example, releasing things like, you know, going to the pub and coming home and having that late night binge fest at the end of it. You know that actually just going to the pub was binge fest enough, or to come home and then stuff yourself full of like toast and biscuits and all those sorts of things. You know, you need to kind of let go of that so that you're not compounding the extra sugar that you're taking on and the extra fluids and all those sorts of things. Do you know that you need to release that before you start your diet, before you start your, you know, sober October or whatever it is that is, you know, you're going to start? And it's the same with the full moon. So the full moon is all about kind of bringing those things to a close so that you can start afresh for the next new moon. And there's 2 weeks between the new moon and the full moon. So you usually have like a kind of a clearing out period between the fall of the new moon and the beginning of the full moon. This is a kind of 2 week period that I want you to kind of think back now as what's been going on in your life for the last couple of weeks. Just think about the things that have come up, any arguments that you've had, regular thoughts that you've been going into, perhaps regular patterns that, you know, haven't really been serving you, you know, getting up late or going to bed late and things like that, stuff that you just think to yourself, you know what, I need to kick this out. I need to kind of start something new, and I'm going to do it from the full moon. That's when I'm closing all that down and starting off something new. So firstly, I want to kind of just introduce you to my little setup here. This is something that I do at home, but I've come around a friend's house because the feminine, it's all about feminine energy this moon. So I've come around to my bestie's house to set up so that we can really bring the feminine energy in and support one another. It's great if you can do these sort of rituals with people because it really builds the energy. But also the stuff that I usually use for my own full moon rituals, I'm kind of bringing in to share with you now. So I'm just going to kind of introduce you to the gang, as it were, and bring you down here. I've made it all out so that you can see what I've got going here. So just to introduce you to the things that I regularly use. So first of all, at the back here, we've got Ganesh. So Ganesh is the remover of obstacles. He's the guy who is, you know, he's going to be your power force going through. He's my power force going through. I use him a lot for my meditations. I use him a lot for enabling myself to be strong, really. Let go of negative self, like self-doubting thoughts, to let go of things that, you know, if I'm second-guessing myself, I tend to look towards Ganesh, the remover of obstacles, and say, that's what's holding me back right now, whether it be a thought pattern. It can be a behavioral thing, you know, like I said, going to bed too late, those sorts of things. You know, he's the guy that guides me. Then I've gotten my candles. So I've bought two candles so that I can use them as a sort of ceremoniously lighting and bringing flame, bringing fire into my ritual. Fire is really, really cleansing. And the significance of the red candles as well is because the red signifies like the root chakra. So that would be the chakra point. Your very base chakra, the very base of your spine is signified by the color red. And it's the root chakra is very much about who you are. It's who I am. It's fears, it's securities, it's that sort of thing. And it determines almost you as a person going forward in your life, is how you're going to carry yourself. But it's also obviously a color that we sort of associate with the heart and with love. And as this full moon is in the middle of Venus retrograde, as I said before, and Venus is the planet of love and kind of relationships and keeping everybody happy and together and all those sorts of lovely things, I felt like the red was a really good, significant color in the candles to be going forward with. Then I have got my crystals. So I've got these crystals that have come from South America with me. I've had them for years and years. I usually leave them out on my... what do you call it, you're in my windowsill, so that the sunlight can really feed them and they can grow. But if you've got any crystals at home that you'd like to use for this ritual, then leave them out under the moonlight after you've done your release ritual as well, and they draw in the power of the moon. Then bring them into the house so that that power of that moon and that intention that you've been setting with them as well is kind of brought into your localized energy, into your home, into the place where, you know, you want that energy to spread. Crystal is an amazing conduct of energy. We use it in computers and stuff like that. Like I found that out just recently. But it's used to transfer information. And so wearing crystals, having crystals on you, having them around the house, different crystals for different things. We won't go into that now. But, you know, you can. There's so many different uses for crystals. And they're just these really great conductors of energy and, positivity. Anything intentional that you've kind of brought into the house, they will help transfer it around and allow the other people in your house to really benefit from everything that you've done for yourself as well. So the next thing I wanted to introduce you to are my mala beads. So these are made out of sandalwood. I got them when I was in Thailand. And there's a bit of a story behind these mala beads. You may have seen me wear them before on my shows, because these were the beads that I had blessed on my ritual that I devised for my grandparents. All three grandparents died when I was living in Thailand. And I absorbed quite a lot of guilt from not being around for them and in the last parts of their lives, but also for not being able to be there around their death, not being able to support my family, and not being able to go to their funerals. So I had quite a lot of guilt on that and quite a lot of shame. And I didn't really realize until I was really, really, really down. And a couple of things happened to me, which basically enabled me to sort of recognize that I was holding all this tension and this pain in my back, which is traditionally where we carry shame, guilt, all that sort of thing that we don't want to look at. You know, the stuff that you feel embarrassed of or conscious of, or you just don't want to face, tends to go into the back, into the shoulders, into the middle spine, but under the shoulder blades. The knot that I found, the tension that I found, was really, really deep down and right underneath my shoulder blades and close to my heart. And as that tension was released, I just began to get visions, and I began to get real awakening feelings of loss and of grief that I hadn't faced before. So I ended up devising myself a ritual to celebrate their lives and to celebrate the life that we shared together. And I walked up to a temple in Thailand near where I live. It was something like 1,263 steps, and all these steps were like vertical, going up a karst mountain. Quite the climb up into through the clouds, monkeys all over the place. Really, really beautiful, beautiful place. If you ever go to Krabi, it's Wat Tham Sua. So go and Google and see what I mean. It's really a stunning place to be. But I went up there and I devised my own little ritual to say goodbye to them and to honor them and to really let them know how much I love them and sort of say all the things that I hadn't said before. When I came down, I went and got blessed by the monks who were chanting and doing their mantra and their prayers first thing in the morning, because I'd gone up there at like 5 a.m. I wanted to see the sunrise. Again, a significant thing, you know, using the changing parts of the world of your day to be able to start new intentions, to start new rituals. Sunrise, particularly, it's the dawn of a new day. It's a new start. You enable yourself to clear things from the past and start right there and now. And we've talked about now and the significance of now in previous shows and how important it is to just, you know, throw caution to the wind. Tomorrow is another day. It will never, you know, right now will never come. So if you want to start anything, do it now. And so I brought all that into the ritual. And when I came down from the temple, I was lucky enough. I kind of went out and I went to this little lady and I was walked past to go and get into my car. There was this little stall and they had all these mala beads. And I kind of wanted just something significant from the temple that I would be able to sort of take home as a little bit of a souvenir, I suppose, really. And I found these mala beads and they caught me because they've got little inscriptions. I don't know if you'll be able to see, but they've got little inscriptions of like Buddha on them and a little symbol for peace and love on them as well. And as you go around in your prayer, you can kind of just feel these inscriptions and then move on to the next one. So that was lovely. But being made of sandalwood, they also smell amazing as well. And they're just 100% wooden. So I bought these. And then when I went down to pay for them to the little lady in this stall, one of the monks who had been chanting and who had been blessed by came out and blessed the beads as well. And I just felt like it was such a special moment, like to have had that whole experience and for it to have gone really well. Like I let go of a lot of upset, a lot of tears were shed. But also I sung songs that we'd sung together. I remembered times that we'd had together vocally out loud, at the top of this mountain into the clouds. And it was really a very special time for me. So to have that little souvenir, now whenever I do anything sort of sacred, I bring these with me just as a contact with my ancestors so that I've got the support of those people that loved me and helped bring me up and always supported me in everything that I did. And really encouraged me to travel and, all the sorts of things that I've really found so beneficial in my life. A lot of it was down to my grandparents, they come from a much harder time and they were very pragmatic about things, go out there, curse, do it, just live life. So the loss was great when I lost them, but now I feel like they're still with me in my mala beads. So I always use them. I've also got with me my essential oil. So I'm using a spiritual blend today of my essential oils, which I'll come back to again in a minute before I apply. I'm using a Palo Santo stick for smudging, which is going to help cleanse my aura. And also towards the end of the ceremony, after our meditation, I've got my singing bowl, which I just drag over here. It's quite heavy. I've got my singing bowl there, which is really the sound therapy is so important when you are being open and honest and intuitive with yourself. If you think about the world was created, we say from the Big Bang, but actually it was probably rather than a Big Bang, it was kind of a big rhythmic sound. And so when you think about sound therapy, you think about really being able to invoke the power of sound into your intention to clear, to vibrate through, to enter every part of your body as sound does, and really instill the intentions that you're setting tonight with the full moon and with everything else around you. That's the point of these things, really, is to really bring a sense of connection into your intentions, that you're connecting with the earth, you're connecting like through the crystals, you're connecting with your aura, your spiritual self, the part of you that extends past your physical, your skin, past your physical being, and cleansing that, this part of you that people read when you walk into a room, this part of you that babies respond to when they're just a few hours old. This is all about your aura being able to read that energy that you carry with you. The significance of Ganesh in my spirituality and the way that I see him as being able to be something that allows me to let go even more fully. And obviously the sound and having my ancestors here as well, just keeping me present, keeping me held accountable almost for my action tonight as well. So that, whenever I wear these beads, I can become aware again of what I've let go tonight. And that significance can kind of resonate past this evening. So we're so, so lucky. You can see the beautiful full moon behind me now. The last couple of full moons that we've had in the UK, you haven't been able to see them. So I'm thrilled that I picked tonight and that it's landed on a Wednesday so that I can be with you all here. And that also it's such a clear night here in the UK. It is cold. You can see I've got my warm clothes on. But it's really, it's quite nice to be out here and just really basking under the beautiful Hunter's Moon. So it's called a Hunter's Moon because it rises. Today it's risen. The moon, the full moon's risen. Actually rose to its like past into our day at about 9 o'clock this morning. But as it rises, it rises as the sun sets, and as it sets, the sun rises. So they call it the Hunter's Moon because you've got the full moon present throughout the entire night. And so, back in the olden days when we were going out and hunting for our food, this would be the perfect evening to go out and hunt boar and hare and deer, all those kind of nocturnal animals that come out at nighttime under the cover of darkness. And with the light of the full moon, you're able to see them and perhaps gather more and more for the village, more and more for your family. And you were blessed by that light. So this is, that's why they call it the Hunter's Moon. So I'm going to start with some of my rituals. Now, while I'm starting and setting up, and you can kind of just watch and listen if you like that. you can, I want you to start thinking about what's been present in your life for about the last couple of weeks. Anything that's been coming up to you, the way behavioral patterns, things that you've been thinking and thinking and thinking about, like just keep coming up, little niggles that really you haven't managed to put to bed, anything like that. So I'm going to start off with my lighting of my candles, just to kind of invoke the power of flame. I've written a few things down about these bits. And then we'll talk about what's happening in the stars and why it's so relevant. So what's that bit of paper? Here we go. No, I don't know what I've done with it. Never mind. Okay, so we're going to start and light the candles just to begin the ceremony. I like to light the candles first. Candles bring out this real sense of just real unmeasured energy into it. You know, obviously they kind of feed off of the energy around them as well. And with spiritual practices, you know, you often see candles being used and invoked. So I always like to start with the candles. Then I'm going to start with my Palo Santo stick. So Palo Santo is a wood that comes from South America. And it helps to cleanse the aura. It helps to bring new energies. It helps to let go of stagnant energies. So basically, I'm just going to kind of light this now. It takes a while to light. You can buy these online. You can get them from, you know, kind of spiritual shops and you know, websites and stuff online. Just going to light it a little bit more. I want it to be kind of not in flame, but I want it to be really smoking. So it's a similar sort of thing as a smudging stick. So if you want to use sage and rosemary and thyme and lavender and all those sorts of things, then you can use those as well. Okay, that's got a good smoke going on it now. And I just take it around my head. So just hold it, thanks. We just take it around my head about three times and cleanse the aura at the top of my body. And then I'm going to take it down my right side, my masculine energy, and then take it around the bottom of my body, around my feet, again, three times, and then bring it up through the left side, which is my feminine energy. And that's going to help to kind of cleanse my aura, cleanse the stagnant energy that I may be carrying around. Smells lovely. This is the sort of thing that as well, you can do this in the house. If you've got bad energy in the house, anything like this, get yourself a Palo Santo stick. And again, light it, burn it, and take it and smudge all around through the house. You can do this like around children. And, you know, there's nothing toxic about this. This is a natural product, completely natural, smells fabulous, and helps us just clear away and also puts you in a little bit of a, you know, a mood for what we're going to be doing here tonight. So I'm just going to put that down there and allow that to go out. The next thing I'm going to be using is my spiritual blend of oil. So I'm just going to read out the significance of this blend. It is a doTERRA blend. I've spoken about doTERRA before. I use doTERRA blends because I trust the company. I trust the quality of the oils. They're certified pure therapeutic blend. So it doesn't get much purer than that where essential oils are concerned. It's a mixture of frankincense, sandalwood, lavender, myrrh, and it's got rose in there as well. And because we are dealing with a full moon that is in Venus retrograde and we're dealing with letting go of sort of things, I thought that actually this oil, the culmination of these oils would be great for kind of holding me into that. So I'm going to place this along my brow, along my third eye. I'm going to place it down the back of my neck. And I'm also going to place it onto my heart chakra. I'm going to have to undo all my little load now because it's going down the front of my tongue. So I'm just going to go around my heart chakra just so that I can invoke the power of these oils. Lovely. So the oil of spiritual insight says it's a wonderful aid for meditation. It quiets the mind, fosters inner stillness, and encourages spiritual growth. While this oil is gentle, it's also very powerful. It assists the release of negativity, darkness, and limiting perceptions, which is exactly what we're focusing on tonight. And this oil can mitigate spiritual blindness and other spiritual issues by offering profound light to individuals. It also offers grace and comfort when one feels discouraged or distressed. It can assist individuals in transcending the darkness, pain, and stresses of life. It offers support in raising levels of human consciousness and preparing individuals for new heights of spiritual transformation. So that for me is kind of just one more thing, one more tool that I can use to help connect in with my spirituality, in with my soul, in with the true feelings of my heart, not the person that I perhaps put on occasionally to the outside world, you know, because I think that I need to fit in or I think that I need to serve in some way. But it just really invites me to be 100% me when I'm going through this ritual, which of course is really important. It's important that even if you can't be honest with other people, that you are honest with yourself. There's no point lying to yourself. You live with yourself every day. It's a long time to have a relationship with somebody you don't trust. So be honest with yourself and take this opportunity as well. It's quite a personal time, full moon rituals. And as much as you can do them with other people, and I'm here with my friend, like I said, tonight, it's also something that you will probably want to prepare for a little bit more on your own. And there are parts of the ritual that you can dip in and out of if you find that you're with people and perhaps you don't want to speak your truth to them. Perhaps actually you just want to kind of say what it is that you feel comfortable in saying. And that's not really what we're trying to invoke with this. We're trying to be honest. We're trying to strip it down bare. And we're trying to kind of really let go of the things that are hampering you in your life, rather than the kind of the persona that we all put on in various different times of our life for various different reasons. So let's talk quickly about what's going on with the planets and everything tonight, why we're under the full moon, all the different influences that are on the full moon as well. I've written it all down. You know me, I like to get prepared. So I've written it all down. And whilst I was writing it down, I came across a beautiful poem as well from Mother Teresa. So I'll read that after. So it's called What's Happening in the Stars. I'm going to read it out. So a full moon occurs when the sun is opposite the moon. This highlights opposing forces or polarities in your life, such as your work versus home, or what you need versus what you want. Inattention and external pressures can lead to personal conflict and crisis that can drain your energy. We've all been there, haven't we? Those things most personal to you, your home, family, and intimate relationships, come into sharper focus on the run-up to and following a full moon. And this is why I say to you, think about what's been going on in the last couple of weeks, since the new moon and before today. Stuff that maybe has been coming up, niggles, things that have really griped you, you know, things like that. See if anything's come up. The lunar qualities of emotions and instincts, which relate to your feminine energy, remember, reach their peak at a full moon. The moon being the representative of divine feminine energy. So try to use your increased emotional strength and intuition to overcome any relationship challenges. Feel into the messages behind the issues that arise. Try to be empathetic towards the other people involved, but also place your needs front and center. Remember, this release ritual is about you letting go. Your energy is going to be affected by this, and that will permeate out into your relationships with other people. But it's really about being open and honest with you. So then the subconscious awareness allows for impartial and balanced look at your personal relationships. We're able to weigh up the issues. And when you're being honest with yourself, you will clearly see any relationship dynamics or negative feelings causing disharmony. The October full moon. So this is the hunter's moon, which I already explained. It earned its name due to the fact that the extra light made it easier for hunters to look for nocturnal animals. So this one is conjunct with Uranus, which means this planet has the main astrological influence on is Uranus, has on main astrological influence on the moon, Uranus has. So interestingly, Uranus takes approximately 84 years to come full circle and is the planet of independence, liberation, and enlightenment. So these opportunities don't come around all that often. this is a good time to feel enlightened, to be liberated, and to really feel, yeah, and, you know, like you're standing true to yourself, that beautiful independence where you are who you are. You make no apologies. You know, this is it. This is me, right? It's here to speed up our tempo in order for us to consider taking risks and making changes. And it's all about considering the future. So it doesn't have patience with lifestyles or attitudes that are attached to the past or the traditional. So you may find that, you know, people's past or previous expectations of you are griping on you. That, you know, the previous kind of roles that you were living in, perhaps especially as women, you know, we might find that we're feeling really challenged about playing small. We're feeling really challenged about, you know, having to do housework and where's the help and why isn't everybody else, you know, on board as well and all those sorts of things. So it's just kind of, you know, noticing that if you've been feeling these things, this is the sort of stuff, these are the boundaries that are being brought up for you to really face and to open a line of communication about, you know, at first with yourself and then go forward and stand true in who you are. This reflection on the moon means that this full moon will shake us up, offering us a chance to be more aware of our individuality. Uranus doesn't accept stagnation, nor does it accept restriction. Imagine that influence on the divine feminine aspect of us all. So, okay, we've been talking about how the divine feminine has been pushed down and, you know, we all need to have our divine feminine rise in us so that we can be more empathetic, we can be more creative with our relationships, with everything that's going on in the world. And so, yeah, so let's just kind of imagine for a second how powerful this moon is for us, for our feminine side. Personal freedom is highlighted. Transiting Uranus acts to awaken and make us aware of our feelings of being restricted and constricted. So anything that's making you feel hemmed in, boxed in, you know, this is what's coming up to be faced. We can expect to feel emotionally surprised, jolted, and stimulated. So if you suddenly burst into tears, if you get really, really angry, if you get really, really frustrated, if you're losing it like that, then, you know, you can blame the moon. You've got a genuine reason. Now, add this to the fact that Venus, the planet of love and relationships, is retrograde at the moment. So that means retrograde means that rather than outward expression of love, it turns inward. You know, it's going backwards, so it's turning inward on itself. We're looking at more internally at how we love, how we're loved, and whether this love or relationship is really working for us. Now, this can be your partner, this can be your significant other, but this can also be within relationships with, you know, children, with parents, all those sort of things. You know, is this relationship that you have with this person supporting you? Is it a positive relationship? You know, begin to look at whatever it is that's coming up. If you've had friction across the family, then begin to look at that as well. But also how you express yourself in that relationship, you know, what it is that it's doing to you if it's negative, and how it is that perhaps you can, you know, change your dynamic as well to enable it to be a more empowered relationship. So maybe over the past couple of weeks, we've been feeling tested in our relationships. If a bond isn't built of solid stuff, it's likely you've been experiencing some turbulence. Obviously, this is an important opportunity to go back and do the necessary work, but it's also an eye opener to see who's willing to put into that investment. You know, you might find people are a little bit more willing or less willing to listen to what you've got to say and to accept and empathize with your position. And of course, those who only show up when things are fun, good and easy, you know, which obviously, you know, you're looking really at someone who's only around for the good times, there, fair weather folk. On a positive note, Venus retrograde could bring a refreshing pause to the dramatic scripts of our love stories, helping us to step back and regain perspective. Are we truly writing ourselves into suitable romantic roles? So are you changing yourself to be something that you believe the other person wants to be? And if not, what can we do to recast or change a less than stimulating plotline? It's not working. It's making things, you know, if things are just humdrumming along, then maybe we want to look at changing that as well. Remember, the directive is to turn inward first. So you're looking at yourself first with everything. You know, you can only ever change yourself. Remember that. Doesn't matter how much you whinge, moan, you know, talk, discuss, you know, help, whatever it is that you feel like you're doing to try and get somebody to understand. You can only ever change yourself. And it's important to remember that. So examining our motives, hidden desires, even exhuming a few past demons we haven't fully dealt with. The prefix re, like as in retrograde, re is where the magic's at. So we're thinking about revive, reunite, repair, restore. You know, this is the power that we're holding when any planet is in retrograde, but specifically in this case, Venus. It's really talking about, you know, what we can do, how we can affect the lives that we're living in, and how we can restore or repair, reunite or revive them. Now, helping Venus out here is Scorpio, which is opposes the full moon, which means it's in the sun sign at the moment. Now, Scorpio is a very direct sign. It takes no prisoners. It's obsessed with stripping things back to the bare bones and getting to the root of what really matters. So Scorpio is going to be helping you to actually support your guide Venus retrograde. Anything that you're looking at, it's going to give you the power. It's going to give you the want to actually face this stuff rather than kind of hiding back in the shadows and just letting it be. It's going to really bring that power into you so that you can, you know, face things and deal with things a little bit more, with a little bit more certainty. What matters to Taurus, which is a star sign that the full moon's rising in, are the things that really endure. So this full moon is teaching us that if our roots are deep and strong, they'll remain firmly planted in the ground, even after the leaves and the flowers begin to die. Trust in life's natural cycle is very apt in autumn, which is what we're experiencing in the UK and in the Northern Hemisphere. So trust in life's natural cycles, keep tending them through the winter, through the change of seasons, and eventually you will see them bloom again. So that's what's happening in the stars. So I was reminded today of a poem that I actually read a couple of weeks ago, and it seemed quite nice with the Venus retrograde. So I just wanted to read it out. It's something that Mother Teresa wrote. I don't know if it's a poem or just kind of a little script, but so it says that people are often unreasonable, irrational, and self-centered. Forgive them anyway. If you are kind, people may accuse you of selfish, ulterior motives. Be kind anyway.
If you are successful, you will win some unfaithful friends and some genuine enemies. Succeed anyway. If you are honest and sincere, people may deceive you. Be honest and sincere anyway. What you spend years creating, others could destroy overnight. Create anyway. If you find serenity and happiness, some may be jealous. Be happy anyway. The good you do today will often be forgotten. Do good anyway. Give the best you have and it will never be enough. Give your best anyway. In the final analysis, it's between you and God. It was never between you and them anyway. And that's from Mother Teresa. So wise words from her. That's fabulous. Okay. Now I'm going to start. The next thing we're going to do is I want to do a heart-centered meditation. Really just to get, or to encourage everybody, including myself, to just drop into feeling into the heart and really recognizing the power and the strength that you have in there. So we've got our candles burning. I've applied the oil. I've smudged. The crystals are out. I'm going to put my mala beads on so that I can really invoke the feeling of my ancestors. I can go around there. And if you can, just sit quietly with your back straight. Doesn't have to be on the floor. You can be sitting quietly on a chair. Just close your eyes. Rest your hands onto your knees or onto your tops of your thighs, wherever's comfortable, so that you can really begin to relax. And bring your attention onto your breath, breathing only through the nose, taking a deep breath in and a long relaxing breath out, beginning to let go of the weight of the shoulders, the weight of the elbows, the weight of the hips, the weight of the legs, allowing the feet to drop down towards the floor and really beginning to bring yourself into a calm position. So just settle yourself for a moment as you move into that space, as you move into a space of being relaxed, being comfortable, and being calm. Keep focusing on your breath, breathing in and out of your nose. And watch the path of your breath as you breathe. So as you breathe in, you're following that cool, calm breath into your body, recognizing that you're taking the energy in there. And as you breathe out, begin to watch how the rib cage, the lungs deflate, the stomach goes soft, sympathetic nervous system begins to relax here. So you may be feeling like your eyes are getting heavy, your eyelids, that the muscles around your face, your skull are all beginning to relax as well. And keep following the path of your breath for about 5 or 6 breaths now, just so that you can really bring yourself into a calm, calm state. And if any thoughts come in, then allow them to come, but allow them to pass as well. Try not to engage in any internal dialogue. Try not to have those conversations we so regularly have with ourselves. Then I want you to close your eyes, if they're not closed already, and put your left hand in on your heart. I want you to feel that beating, feel that stillness, and the rest of your body as you breathe in and out, connecting in with your heart center, with that area around your lungs, above your internal organs, below your throat. And keep your hands resting there for a moment so that you can really connect in with yourself. Now in your mind's eye, I want you to begin to picture your heart. And I want you to picture your heart not as a dark red muscle constantly moving, but as an energy source that feeds and nourishes your whole body. Feel that energy with each beat of your heart onto your hands. Feel that connection you have in with yourself. Feel and trust in with your heart. It doesn't let you down. Even when you're not conscious of the work it's doing, it's still there working for you. Now in your mind's eye, begin to picture your heart as a ball of energy, like a small sun. And it's not yellow like the sun. It's a beautiful, vibrant green. And as you breathe in, this vibrant ball of energy begins to expand. And as you breathe out, it begins to relax. And try to align your vision alongside your breath and take beautiful deep breaths in so that you're drawing as much energy into your body as you possibly can. Feel that ball of energy expanding out towards the edges, the confines of your heart cavity, coming towards your lungs, going towards your rib cage. And as you breathe out, it doesn't shrink, it just relaxes in that state. Take 4 or 5 deep breaths, drawing the breath into your heart space as energy that's feeding this sun, this ball of expanding energy that you've got in your heart cell. And as you breathe in, feel the power of that heart chakra come out towards the outside edges of your skin and filling your whole chest. Feel it warming the cavity around your heart, your lungs, through to your shoulders, up towards your neck. Feel the power that you hold inside you, that truth, that knowing. The heart center is where we take our intuition from. The part that we can really trust, never be deceived, will always put you first. So as you breathe in that knowledge as well. Breathe faith into your heart. Breathe that trust in and expand it out through your body. Taking that awareness, taking that love out, not just through the chest now, but up towards your crown chakra, towards the top of your head. And gradually down, down towards the root chakra at the base of your spine. Feeling that warmth begin to touch into your legs. And moving all the way down your legs and towards your feet, which are grounded onto the floor, so that you can connect your energy with the earth energy. Keep breathing. Keep focusing on your breath. Keep feeling that warmth, that beautiful energy expanding and relaxing, expanding and relaxing. Now I want you to take a deep breath in and bring your right hand up and on top of your left hand so that it covers your heart. You begin to bring this all full circle. Take another deep breath in and draw your attention out of your heart space and back towards your third eye, the area between your eyebrows, or Agni Chakra. And then slowly begin to take your awareness back down towards the tip of your nose where your breath comes into your body and leaves your body. Now take a deep breath in and as you breathe out, gently dip your head down towards your heart. Keep your eyes closed. And then as you breathe in, begin to open your eyes and raise your head. And still feel that connection in with your heart. Now the next part of our full moon mantra, our full moon meditation and ritual is to really write down any of the things that have been bothering you over the past couple of weeks, could be over the past year,
anything that you know you need to let go, and you want to invoke the power of this beautiful Taurus new moon to do. Take a moment, get a pen, get a piece of paper, and write down anything that has been bothering you, worrying you, anything that's kind of been there for you, niggling away, something that needs to be faced, something that needs to be brought to your attention. And just begin to jot that down. So I have prepared something earlier. I didn't want to be writing down in front of you all, but this might give you some idea of something that you want to let go. These are personal things that I'm going to be letting go of this full moon. So the next part of the ritual is, once you've written it out, and I've got mine on my piece of paper here, you have two choices. You can read it back to yourself and really recognize what it is that you need to let go of, all those things. You know, you've written it out. It's been expressed from thought into word via your physical self. So really manifesting through the three parts of you, mind, body, and spirit. You've written it all down, and you have a choice now. You can either say it to yourself, or you can say it out to the universe. When I mean out to the universe, I don't mean anyone particularly has to hear you. I mean, you just speak your truth out into the universe, towards the moon, ideally, within the scope of the moon's rays. So I'm going to read out what I've written down. These are obviously personal to me, and they've been coming up for a while and just recently. So in front of the full moon, there she is, looking gorgeous. These are the things I'm letting go of. I'm letting go of the feeling that because I'm not the main breadwinner in the family, that I have a lesser role. My needs for support for the family, for my business, and for myself are just as valid and important. And I release the fear of asking for them and renounce the attachment I have made with them and the energy of money. I'm letting go of picking up after everyone. My children are now more than able to pick up for themselves and take responsibility for the mess that they create. I release the fear of feeling as though I'm stepping away from being needed by them, and I step into the role of empowering them to begin looking after themselves. I will no longer enable them to treat the house, their homes, all rooms and spaces with a lack of respect. My husband is also more than able to pick up after himself. I release the fear of asking him to help me by picking up after himself and the negative impact that has on me as I associate his unwanted thoughtlessness with my role as a woman in the house negatively. Makes me feel as though I'm taken for granted, and I need to be honest with him about that. I'm letting go of a poverty mindset. I release the conditioning I received as a child that money is hard to come by, and that if you help or serve others, that you will always be poor. I understand that this vision was given to me by my parents, and it was given to me to push myself into challenging myself more than I was doing when I was a child. I recognize that I now give 110%, and that you get out what you put in by the law of cause and effect and the law of attraction. I release the old thought patterns that I surrounded myself with around money and its energetic flow, and I embrace with gratitude the knowledge I have now that only through abundant thought will abundance be created. I have seen this. I have experienced this. I must keep remembering it. So those are the things that I'm letting go. And it felt really good to write those down. These are things that are little niggles and big niggles. The little niggles would be the first two, but the last one, the letting go of the poverty mindset, is something that I've really been struggling with for quite a while now. And it's manifested in all our areas of my life. And it holds me back. And I'm really ready to let go of it now. So as much as I've written it down on the piece of paper, now I'm letting go of that piece of paper. You know, the intention has been set. I know what it is that I need to do. I have spoken my truth out to the universe, and I've asked for it to be heard. And I know that it will be. So the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to ceremoniously burn the paper using the flame from my candle. And I'm going to move over to my friend's lawn so that I don't burn around the house. So I'll set it alight here. You can come with me, I think. Thanks, look. There you go. Em's going to help me. She can help me. She's listened to me whinge on about this.
So it's only fitting that she should be there when this all goes up in flames. It's lovely. So we'll just go over where it's a bit safer to be able to let this go. And I love how these things burn. Might need to bring it over here. Keep going. It's only burnt half of it. No. No. It doesn't want to go. It does want to go. I'm ready. I'm ready, Moon. There we go. Let's set this alight again. Make it happen. There. Yeah. Lovely. And you can see that that's just burning up now in light of the full moon behind. Hope you can see that. That's all the stuff that's been holding me back. Going up in flames feels good. It's actually my favorite bit of the whole ritual, really, is watching it go up in flames. It feels good. Now, you've spent time thinking about it. You spent time writing it all down. You spent time going over whether, or, you know, the, like with me as well, there's guilt about even saying it. You know, I've got guilt about speaking my truth. That's probably something else I need to be letting go of as well. That's something else that I need to be letting go of as well. But it's all of those things. And it's being able to let go of it all and just remember that, you know, it's good to cleanse. It's good to release things. It's the natural cycle of life. You know, this is how we come in and we go out and, you know, we leave something behind. There's always a resonance of somebody behind. But it's, you know, I want that to be a positive resonance. I want my life to mean something. Not existentially across the universe or anything like that, but I want it to have been heard by the universe. I was brought in by the universe. I want to go out with the universe as well. So now that I've done that, I like at the end of my, you know, kind of a release and ritual, I like to finish it with sound, my sound therapy. So, thank you. So I'm going to play my singing bowl. Now this bowl resonates at a vibration that connects in with your third eye and your root chakra. So this one's perfect for what we're doing now. It's, you know, your third eye is connection with insight. It's the connection with self and soul. And your root chakra, again, is releasing your fears. It's the person that you are. It's, you know, being able to stand tall in as who you are. So I'm just going to begin. And I love the meditation bowl specifically because the sound grows. And I hope you can hear that. I'm bringing it close to my face because I've got one of these little microphones on. But this low sound really resonates deeply with your root chakras. Vibrating through the spine when you hold these bowls close. And then the higher tempo that we get from the knock resonates in with the third eye. And my magic numbers are 3 and 5. So I'm going to do 3 turns. And 5 knocks. I love it. I hope you can hear this vibration. You can't feel it, but I can feel it's coming through my hand, into my arm, into my chest. In fact, I'm holding it in my left hand so that it can connect directly in with my heart. So third and final root round. It's beautiful, deep sound. And that sound therapy just resonates through me, the intentions that I've set tonight. Again, begins to vibrate through and clear any negative energy, any self-doubts, anything. I've let it all go. And with the last one,
set my intention to step forward. After not only asking for what I want, but knowing that I need to stand tall and say what it is that I want as well. And it feels good. Feels nice. I like the fact that I've even said it out to the universe, let alone anything else. It's like sometimes just saying those things that go around in your mind all the time. It's just nice to have your voice heard. I think that's what we get a lot from friendship. You know, whenever me and Emma meet up, we always have a good old natter and, you know, we put the world to rights and stuff. And you get so much from it, just having your voice heard. So now that goes down there. Put that on there so it doesn't roll off. I'm going to leave my crystals out under the moon. Leave my candles burning. And wish you all a wonderful full moon release ritual. If you want to replay this over, it will be up in a couple of days. And in the light of in the waning of the full moon, it's still as powerful. You know, your intention setting can be done at any time. And you can use these ritual things to be able to set intentions any time. So just because I've chosen to do this outside and under the full moon, just to really be able to connect with the natural energies of the universe and of the world, doesn't mean to say that I couldn't be doing this on a Tuesday afternoon when I've just about had enough and I know that I need to shift something, you know. So don't feel that you can't invoke these rituals whenever you need them. You don't have to wait for a full moon. It's just that somehow I think with this kind of magical moon behind me and the clarity of the night makes me feel really, it makes me feel really special. So it's a much shorter one than I usually do, but wishing you all a wonderful, wonderful October Hunter's full moon. And I'll see you next week for another episode of This Happy Guru. Namaste. Good night.
Humanity has been on an epic journey of discovery, learning the truth about the world we live in. New discoveries about the true origins of humanity, ancient history, free energy, as well as the systematic corruption of world governments are now on the forefront of our daily reality. Is the world headed towards destruction based on control and power? Or is an opportunity now being presented to shift and uplift into a higher consciousness? My name is Mel V, co-founder and creative director of Conscious Consumer Network, an independent broadcast network that was launched on the 1st of January 2015. In the last 3 years, Conscious Consumer Network has broadcast over 2,800 shows in multiple languages, featuring guests from across the world, whilst creating media that is aimed at the creation of a free, fair, peaceful, just, sustainable world. Conscious Consumer Network provides full training and an interactive support network for all broadcasters, and we are always looking for inspiring and educational content.
Hi, this is Lainey Liberty.
And this is Miro Siegel.
In 2018, Conscious Consumer Network has expanded to multiple broadcast locations, increasing our availability and reach across the world, remaining on the cutting edge of independent media. If we wish to create a better world, we must first create better media, geared towards real education instead of indoctrination.
You guys really are what changing the world is going to be about. It's educating kids at a grassroots level.
Having become a pillar of stability in the turbulent world of independent media, we have even more going on in 2018. Conscious Consumer Network is a publicly funded network, and we rely on all of you to keep us on the air. Show your support for independent media by donating to our 2018 Network Support Fund. Dare to seek a better world. Support independent media.